got to know Jesus in many ways over many years. I was taught about Jesus as a child. I had faithful parents that taught me scriptures, encouraged me to memorize scriptures. I was in Sunday school. I was in children's church. I was in church my whole life. I tried to do right. I tried not to get into trouble. When I was a young adult, very young actually, I was married at 18 and left home and went with my new husband over to Seattle, and I was so lonely. I didn't know anybody. And in that loneliness, I cried out to Jesus. And something new I learned about Jesus. He isn't just someone you know as a story or a distant figure. He is very real. And one night at church, I was just crying my 18-year-old heart out. And in my heart, I heard him say, "My grace is sufficient for you." That was the first time I ever knew that Jesus would speak to you in your heart. It wasn't in my ears, it was in my heart. And it was right out of his word that he spoke to me. I didn't know that you could actually intentionally listen for his voice until some years later. Again, a young adult, in a very traumatic way, we were catapulted to Alaska and landed in a church where there were really believing believers. It wasn't tradition, it wasn't stifled, it wasn't legal, it was biblical, but it was alive. And there I learned that the Word of God was alive. I had done my duty as a kid. I knew to be faithful to all this stuff. But in that place, I realized there was so much more that I never knew. I want to tell you a little history here. In the mid-1800s in California, gold was discovered. In fact, the classic cry was, "There's gold in them thar hills." And they went out to gather gold, and it was sitting right on the ground. There was gold in stream beds, gold sitting around where they could just see it and pick it up. And the gold was okay, but it wasn't very pure. So once they gathered up all the gold that was easy to get, sitting on the surface, they started going into the hills. And you might have a picture in your mind now of the old miner and his old burrow and his pickaxe and dusty, dirty work, and up into the hills they'd go, and they would cut into the mountainside and they would dig out caves. And deep in those caves, deep in the dark, is where the pure gold was found. There were streams of gold in the rock. In fact, when they hit a big streak of gold, they'd call it a mother lode. So what does that have to do with how do I know Jesus? As I grew up, as a child, as a young adult, I knew Jesus like the things you know that are sitting on top of the ground. As life went on, I found myself in deep, dark caves, in deep places of life that were difficult, and it was in there that I found pure gold of Jesus and his word.
I cannot.
With the growing knowledge that Jesus was found in the deep places, I discovered something else. I discovered how fearful I was. I was fearful because I didn't know he loved me. In all the gathering of gold, the knowing of Jesus, memorizing of scriptures, knowing the Bible stories, I didn't know he loved me. There was a broken place in me, and I didn't even know how to know he loved me. So as time went on, he did a whole lot of work to show me that he loved me. And I want to tell you about one special time. I was in had a very awful, awful thing happen in my life. On the morning, the news of it came to me while I was trying to get ready to go teach a Bible study. And I thought, how am I going to teach a Bible study when I can't even get myself together here? But I'm determined and I was committed. So out the house I went. And as I was going up my street, alongside the curb came a little squirrel. and he was loping along the curb like squirrels do, and there were three trees that he aimed for. He hit one, the second one, and up the third one he went. Before even seconds elapsed, here came another squirrel. Same dance, down the curb, up one tree, second tree, third tree, up the third tree. Faster than I can explain it. All in all, seven squirrels came down the curb doing the same dance, up a tree, second tree, third tree. And I knew who choreographed that dance. It could only have been Jesus. And what that said to my heart was, I see you. And I'm going to send you something, and you'll know it's from me. And so over time, my knowing of Jesus, I found him in the deep places, in the dark places. And he faithfully has spoken to me when I've been near death, when I've been traumatized, when I didn't know what to do. He has spoken to me again and again. How has that changed my heart? I can trust him. I know whom I have believed, and he is able to keep that which I've committed to him against that day. If I knew I had a day to live, what I want to tell you is Jesus speaks. Jesus even said, man doesn't live by bread alone, but by every word that comes out of the mouth of God. Job said, he knows the way that I take, and when he has tried me, I shall come forth as gold. My foot has held his steps, his way have I kept. I've esteemed his word more than my necessary bread. I am here to tell you, his word is that great. Don't leave it sitting on top of the ground. Dig, be a miner, get the tools, dig in there, because you'll find life there. The blessings of Jesus have come to me in ways I never expected. There have been material blessings and relational blessings and restoration to health blessings, but those could all change. Those could all change. The unexpectedness for me of his blessings were he invites us to know him. I never expected that. And I never knew what a blessing it is to know him. We don't know him fully, but the measure that he has drawn me into knowing him is beyond anything I could have ever expected. I can look into the eyes of someone who's suffering and have the confidence that to say to them, I know, but I also know the one who will help you. He's taken me not from just having an answer or having a story, but he's taken me to a place where I know him more than I ever imagined I could know him. He has changed me. I was an orphan. I was thrown away. I was adopted and blessed, but much of my life has been being abandoned and rejected, and that was very frightening to me. The blessing is, I've come to know the one who says, I will never, no, never, not ever leave you or forsake you. I can tell you, I've been in dark places in the night, weeping my heart out, and he's been there. I didn't expect that, but he was there. I've been in deep, dark hospital basements when they're about to do something big and painful, and he was there. Wherever I have gone, I've discovered he got there first. I love Jesus, and I'm so grateful to tell you it's possible to know how much he loves you.